What's up guys, Dr. Feelgood here, back again with another video prescription. And today I want to talk about some complaints I've been hearing from key people. People that I know. I don't necessarily associate myself with them, but there are people that I know. But I am constantly hearing some people say that to them there is nothing to play on the Nintendo Switch. And I'm just wondering, what fucking console library of games are they looking at? But then, here's the kicker. They will admit that they don't believe there's nothing to play because there's no new Nintendo games. Huh. So, okay. While even that is not necessarily valid, let's have a fair comparison, shall we? Let's have a fair comparison. If you honestly believe that there is nothing to play on the Nintendo Switch merely because there are no new Nintendo games to play, then let's take that same rationale and use it against the other consoles. Alright? Y'all ready for this? So, nothing to play on the Switch because no first party content. Okay, let's look at the PS4 real quick. How many Sony developed games were released for the PS4 in 2014? I won't count the launch year because, I mean, it was only out for a month or two. Okay? But 2014. How many Sony-developed games were there to play? And I know this may seem unfair to you because what was the number one complaint of the PS4 during its first 2 or 3 years on the market? That they claim greatness awaits, but there were no major exclusives for the console. It was mostly just indie games. Hell, the most popular game during its first year was a launch title called Resogun, which is, in fact, an indie game. But no, I want you to use that same logic. Think about how many games developed by Sony were available on the PS4 in 2014. And also apply that to Xbox. How many Microsoft developed games were available on the Xbox One in 2014. And also for the same consoles, let's look at 2015 and then 2016 and 2017 and then 2018. That's all I'm saying. Let's take a real good look at that. Now, I know some of you are probably thinking, well, the PS4 had Spider-Man and they had Bloodborne. But as I stated, we're talking about Sony-developed games. We're not talking about third-party exclusives or anything like that. Because, let's be honest, in 2019, the Switch had more than a few good exclusive games that were not indies. But yet all I'm hearing is from these people is that there's nothing to play. So I will consider your argument. I'm just asking you to be fair across the board. So outside of God of War on the PS4, which I believe was 2018, What were you guys playing? How many Sony exclusives developed by Sony? I don't think it's that many. And I don't even have to bring this up when it comes to the Xbox One, right? I'm just saying. And I remember hearing this same thing about the Wii U back in 2015. But did you guys know that Nintendo released 7 games for the Wii U developed and published by themselves for the Wii U in 2015? And some of you are probably thinking, that's a lie. Okay. And I'm talking about just Nintendo developed games here. Let me count them out for you. This is the Wii U in 2015, arguably considered, you know, the worst year for them in a sense. But you have Splatoon, Super Mario Maker, Mario Party 10, Kirby and the Rainbow Curse, Yoshi's Woolly World, Animal Crossing Amiibo Festival, and Mario Tennis Ultra Smash. That's 7 Nintendo developed and published games that came out for a failing console. Now, I can go further and count the exclusives such as Xenoblade Chronicles X, Pokken Tournament. You know, I can go further. But since there's nothing to play because there's no Nintendo games, okay. So what came out for the PS4 in 2019? I'm not going to look it up. I want you to look it up and be fair in your comparison. I'm not talking about exclusives. I'm talking about Sony developed games. Not your Red Dead Redemptions. Not, you know, Grand Theft Auto and other games like that that are third party games that didn't reach the Switch. I'm talking about how many first party developed games released for both the Xbox One and the PS4 since there's nothing to play. Since when it comes to Nintendo, that's all you bastards want to count. You know, I'm getting sick of it, actually. It doesn't bother me at all, but just wanted to bring that up, give you something to think about. If you only count Nintendo games, which basically what you're saying is you only count first-party titles, then the other consoles look horribly worse. You should really be bitching up a storm when it comes to the Xbox One and the PS4. Now, I know you're going to move the goalposts and say, well, they got major third-party games such as Call of Duty and Red Dead Redemption and Grand Theft Auto and, you know, just other big third-party titles. But your complaint with the Switch is that there are no new Nintendo games to play. I'm just saying. But anyway, I want to know what you guys think about this in the comments. And as I always say, keep it gaming.